Jim, it feels like we were just here a moment ago.
We were.
Doing this same thing.
We were. So it's really one of those things where if you just close your eyes and you think about, I was just here, you are in the same place. It's a time thing.
More and more people are emailing and asking about this time thing. So let's talk about it.
So we talk about time, numbers of times. So time is really an interesting thing, and it has a lot to do with, or a lot of this has to do with, what do you want to experience? So I talk a lot about time. People say time is going faster. You know, I'm running out of time. I don't have enough time. Actually, time is slowing down. And so it takes a little bit. You got to hear this logic or illogic, depending on how you hear it. So I use this example often in the work. So if you, every day of your life, you walk from point A to point B, and it takes you 5 minutes. You can do it with your eyes closed. You know where you are virtually anywhere along that little path. And as time begins to slow down, what happens is what took 5 minutes to get from A to B, now you have less time. You have 4 minutes. But in order to get to that point, you have a sense of, I have to hurry up. I don't have enough time.
And that's where it feels like time is going faster.
Yeah, so I'm moving faster, or I'm running out of time. So both those statements are right. I'm running out of time, but I feel like I don't have enough time. That's true too. But the brain or the logic says, I have to hurry up. I have to hurry up in order to experience this. The day is just disappearing. I'm working harder.
How is it slowing down?
So as you begin to get into present time, because this transition that we're in, we're all moving from this third dimensional linear time game that we play into present time. Everything exists in present time. There is no past. You had a past present time moment. Like right now, we're having this moment. That moment now is in the past.
Right.
Well, that's a concept that is hard for people to understand. They say, well, I lived in the past. The past exists. Well, the past present moment is no longer a present moment. That past present moment is just simply a memory. Let's call it a memory. And it's a piece of information. And your future doesn't exist either, except there is a future present time moment that you'll step into. So one of the things that happens as you start to get into present time, as you start to become more conscious, as you start to simply begin to have more awareness. We've talked about certain and capable
right.
and all of the internal guidance in the heart. When you start to basically be right here, you start to find that time plays out in your head differently. It's very real, but you start to perceive it differently.
So if what usually takes 5 minutes to walk from A to B and time is slowing down, that means it's going to take me only 4 minutes. No.
Well, you only have 4 minutes to get to 5 minute point.
So, to
B. Right. So I just lost 20% of my time. I have to go 20% faster from 5 minutes to 4 minutes.
Well, that would be time is speeding up.
No, time is getting smaller and shorter. And sure, I'm only in present time. But to get to that place out here, my brain says, I have to run because I'm running out of time. I have to go faster. I feel like I'm going faster. Does that make any sense? So, but really what's happening is, it's not about, it's when you try to play the game in 3D where I have to go to everything, where I have to hurry up to get here and hurry up to get there. All of a sudden, when you don't have enough time, you only did 6 things in your day, and you really had 10 things on your plate. I ran out of time. That's exactly right. You ran out of time. But when you begin to get into present time, something really changes. You start to find that things just take care of themselves. When you stop stressing and you stop worrying and you stop holding your attention out into, oh my gosh, I don't have enough time, you start to find that things just take care of themselves.
Well, that's some of the feedback. That's some of what people are saying, that mm-hmm. they have a to-do list and they have 10 things on their to-do list and they get them all done before noon.
Right. So, and then it actually gets very interesting, because as you really get into present time and you start to just not put your attention out there, not worry out there, not be in fear out there, all of a sudden you find that not only did you do the 10 things on your list and it's only noon, you actually begin to have a whole lot of time on your hands. It's like, well, I don't know what to do with myself. I am right here in present time.
Right, and that's something I'm noticing in my own mm-hmm. work day, mm-hmm. is that for the first time ever, my list is accomplished.
Earlier in the day. Yeah.
And you're right, it's a very present time moment. I'm just taking one step in front of the other, and I'm not worried about how much am I going to get done, or mm-hmm. I'm not worried about anything. I'm just, okay, this is what it is today, and surprise, it's done early.
And when you really take a look at a person who's in 3D in their normal world, the amount of time you spend at getting something done is, you spend a lot of time, but there's so many intervals where the phone rings, mm-hmm. I answer a different email, I start thinking about, I begin to be, so you're constantly in this distraction, not doing the thing that's on the plate
right,
more often than
right.
not. You're in distraction. Well, distraction is that third dimensional world that we've all grown up in. And in the third dimensional world, we believe that there's a future that we have to do something about, and we in a past that we either don't want to deal with or we hope doesn't come and bite us in the butt. But that sense of motion is really about this linear time.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's tremendously full of distraction. Most of the distraction is simply noise. And so when a person starts to say, and I virtually everybody has done this, it's like, okay, I have to get myself together, right? And what they're really saying is, okay, I've got to be right here. All right, now here's my list of 6 things and I've got to get them done. So I'm going to really pay attention and I'm going to do these. And inevitably, if you pay attention in present time, the list pretty much mm-hmm. gets done. Sometimes you bump into things that now I have to wait for somebody to get back to me, but you can scratch it off your list. I did that. Now mm-hmm. I have it on my to-do list for when they ever get back to me.
So you said something, though. You said distractions. And so, is it the distractions that make you feel like you're running out of time?
It's no. It's actually time is slowing down. Now, so we've been playing a game that we've all grown up in, linear time. If you ask somebody, 100 people on the street, is there any other kind of time than 100 people will tell you, no, of course. In fact, nobody even pays attention to time because it just is.
Mm-hmm.
When you start to get into this present time space, and for those that are really becoming more spiritual, what begins to happen at some point, that noise, that distraction, you start to realize, I am fine right here. I'm in present time, and things are working. There's a huge shift that occurs, and this is for people, if you're really serious about this spiritual space, this is a key fundamental piece.
Mm-hmm.
Most people will intellectualize this, but when you begin to live in present time, instead of needing to go to everything begins to come to you. So it's that oddity, that problem I had just somehow got solved. Or I had this thought about going to the movies and somebody just called me and said, I want to go to the movie. So you begin to first have these coincidences.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, this is kind of fun, coincidence. And then it happens again and again and again. And for a person that's paying attention, all of a sudden you say, wow, this is really interesting. So you now in present time, you begin to have a thought or an intention and you don't need it or you don't hurry up or I put my attention into the future and it's got to happen this way. As soon as you put I got to have it or I lean into mm-hmm. it or I've move towards it, mm-hmm. you're in the future. But once you begin to just allow it in present time, you start to find that time works very differently. In that space, there's five different configurations of present time. Yeah. Happens differently. Each one happens differently. But to a great extent, a person who's basically understanding and living in present time all of a sudden starts to have a whole different access to consciousness, because they're no longer fighting or mm-hmm. worrying about or leaning into that third dimensional distraction. When you begin to get into present time without the need and the worry and have a sense of yourself, you begin to start to remember yourself. You begin to start to access from these different layers of consciousness how things work in different layers of consciousness that you don't pay any attention to when you're in running around in need and fear.
So I understand present time and I understand linear time. What are the five aspects of present time?
Well, let me just give you two, because the two can be somewhat heard. There's a spiral time, spiraling time, or circular time. And one of the things that happens, you've had experiences in your past. A lot of times those experiences come around. You ever hear people say, oh no, not this again?
Yes.
Well, when you begin to understand how to use circular time, there are things that happened in your past that become information or history that you can draw from. And when you start to have an intention, oh, I did this once, I would like to use that to make this happen in my future, mm-hmm. you start to draw from this past information, not past time, just past information, and you create a circular set of events that allow that information and from that point of past time to be drawn into this current time to be used as an application of creation rather than an event that accidentally jumps up and bites you in the butt.
So an example would be, in the past, I made a really good chocolate cake. Mm-hmm. And I want to make a chocolate cake now, so access that moment when I made the chocolate
sure.
cake so I can repeat it.
Sure. That's a piece of information
yeah.
from the past that you draw on. That's really being very simple. It gets more involved and more fascinating. But yeah, that works. So I draw that event mm-hmm. from my past mm-hmm. into my present and I get to utilize it. Then there's a place when it gets, when you really begin to have an understanding. So this is more conceptual, but in that very present spiritual space where you start to turn yourself back on, you remember yourself, there's simultaneous time. Everything happens in simultaneous time. And so when people start talking about past lives and future lives, for example, let's just say they're real, but they're happening right now. That really begins to be very interesting when you have access to aspects of yourself that are happening in other frame mm-hmm. of reference, mm-hmm. other configurations of consciousness. And it's not so much, oh, was I the king or the prostitute? It's I need a piece of information on how to in present time. So let's call it a library of lifetimes. So you begin to draw from those libraries and you start to say, how does this work? That begins to be really fascinating because that's the space where you hold out your hand and the apple
yeah.
appears. So it's a whole different frame of physics that begins to happen, but it all happens from this configuration of mm-hmm. time. So like you said right at the beginning of this, didn't we just do this? Well, here's a great game to play is basically somewhere you've sat in the same chair, and if you just sit in the chair and say, isn't this where I was the other day? It is exactly the other day. Now, you have to kind of play with that and allow it as a concept, but feel it. It's like, yeah, I was just here. So you and I go to Belize in the wintertime, and we sometimes, like you said last night when we went to bed, let's just be in our bed in Belize and close your eyes and there you are.
Mm-hmm.
It's not even a question. there you are. Now, you could say, no, I'm not there. So that's the 3D piece. But if you just simply close your eyes and feel that bed, and there's the door, and there's the window, and you know, there's the gecko up on the wall.
Right, and you hear the birds.
And you hear the birds, and you have complete present time awareness right here, right there.
Yeah, yeah.
And so that gets to be a whole nother part of time, the ability to be in two places simultaneously. Now, stay out of taking two bodies, making two physical bodies. But this becomes really valuable because understanding it, not logically thinking it, but simply being able to be in the bed in Belize and in the bed right here. But if you can start to be right here and have a consideration of a future moment or something that you would like to see happen in a future moment and start to create it as if it's happening, you will surprise yourself that when you step into that event, it happens pretty much like you had. But play with it and it starts to happen.
Let's play with that.
Exactly, as you had.
Yeah.
So time in present time is different. But when you're worried about or leaning right now because time is slowing down to get everybody into present time, it's a whole shift of consciousness. Mm-hmm. It's a huge piece of this spiritual transition. But if you'll just play with it, you'll start to find that you begin to have time on your hands versus hurry up, I'm running out of time in fear in the third dimension.
Yeah, that's what people are saying they're experiencing.
Yeah. But you have to be intentional. It's not an intellectual, oh, I'll see if he's right. No, it's not I'm right or wrong. It's simply, it's all about you. How do you choose? Play with this and you'll start to surprise yourself with different outcomes than may typically be your case. So.
Good. Play.
Time. Play.